Today we are going to do our first chapter, grammar chapter actually. It is tense. And we are starting with basic use of to be verb, which is is, am, are. Okay. First is that where do we use is, am, are? Is, am, are we can use for making a statement. We can use it for when we have a kind of feeling, any feeling, and we can describe that with it also. Okay. First, for example, there is another two. I am sick. Okay. It is your statement, general statement. You can say I am sick, and for making negative, you can say I am not sick. I am okay. Okay. The second is he, she, it means this one more word for singular person. Singular person, first person. I, we use am. Okay. And for singular third person, we use is. And there are plural persons. First person. Second person and third person. We use are for all of these. Okay. We can say he is good student. Okay. It is a statement. And we can say he is not a good student. Okay. And then. And the third example is which we use with plurals are we are rich. Okay. And we can say you are not rich. We can say they are not rich or they are rich. Okay. The other thing is that we have another thing in this is am are. We can create a question. For example, I am writing right here. Is he sick? Or the first is am I sick? The third is they are rich, you are rich, we are rich, we can write. Are they rich? Okay. In this sense, we can ask them the questions to anybody, and we can question to ourselves. Okay, this is the first part of simple present. I am going to repeat to be verb. Its present forms are is, am, are, and these are used for basic things. Like statements, facts, and feelings. Okay, let's move on. Simple present. Simple present tense, which is also called simple indefinite. Its formation is subject, verb's first form, and object. And with the verb we use s or es when the subject is singular. Okay, and this is used for me when we have to make a statement regarding habit, routines, facts or any permanent condition. For example, I speak the truth. It is my habit. You are not saying that I have spoken the truth only this time. Okay? It may be of once, but here it is your habit. You will always speak and you are speaking in the past also. And he wakes up early. It is your habit, it is your routine. You wake up early. We live in forever. It is a permanent condition. ऐसा नहीं है कि हम आज रहते हैं कल नहीं रहेंगे means just not like that. We are living here permanently. We live in Florsburg. And general facts. The earth revolves around the sun. It is a fact, general fact. And for these things we use simple present and repeated its formation is subject verb first form plus object. Okay, the other thing is that when we have to make them negatives, what do we do? For example, I am going to speak. I speak the truth. And this time I have to say I don't speak the truth. Okay? And for that we use do. Do use for plurals. When the subject is plural, we use don't. I don't speak the truth. It is not my habit. I don't speak the truth. Okay? He wakes up early. And for this, because it is singular, and we will use here does. For singular subjects, we use does. He does not wake up early. And this S, we will remove it. Okay? For making negative, we will use does and we will remove as we use with the single. singulars. He does not make up alone. It is not his habit. Okay, we live in plural. Somebody can ask you, where do you live? So we can simply say, we live in plural. And when the person asks you, do you live in Bhoga? So you can say, no. In case you live in Bhoga, then you can say, we don't live in Bhoga. Means, we live in Bhoga. The earth goes, and in this sentence, we can't say, the earth does not revolve around the sun. Okay, means, it would be a blunder if you call it, the earth does not revolve the sun. It is totally wrong. The other thing which I have written here, is and are. Okay, it is a fact that you can never ever, you will never use is and are in these kind of sentences. You can't say he is live in Bhoga. I repeat, he is live in Bhoga. It is totally wrong. It is never used. Okay, let's move on. It is simple present. I will send you the exercise. We are going to do present continuous. Here, what is the formation of this composition? Subject is and are plus verbs first form ing plus object. It is its formation. I repeat, present continuous tense. And its formation is subject is am are. We use with singular is, with I first person singular, am, and with plural it may be third person or maybe second person or maybe first person. We use are verbs first form, and with this verb form we use ing plus object. Okay, this is its formation. And where do we use this kind of sentences? We use for the things which we are doing, writing, whatever we are doing at the right moment, at the time of talking. For example, if anybody asks you what she is doing, we can say she is writing a letter. It means at this moment. Mean for example, you can ask what are you doing? I am taking a class. Means I am teaching. Means at this moment I am teaching. For present, we use these kind of things. We are going to the market. Where are you going? We are going to the market. Okay. And third is example is what are they doing? They are dancing. Means right now they are. They are dancing right now at this moment. At this time, they are dancing. So many them negative. What we have to do? She is just simply at not. She is not right there. We are going to the market. We are not going. Where are you going? Are you going to the market? No. We are not going to the market. Are they dancing? No. They are not dancing. Simply at not, and it will be negative. Questions I have asked many questions. For example, is she writing a